Welcome to this brief guide on how to set up Bluesnooze on macOS. If you're like me and pair your Bluetooth headphones to both your Mac and your phone, you'll have probably come across the annoyance where your Mac is supposed to be asleep, but your Bluetooth headphones connect to it automatically. Today, I'm going to show you how to fix this issue with a free open source program called Bluesnooze. This program is available publicly via the GitHub website, and I'll include a link to it in the description of this video. Bluesnooze is a free program that does two simple things. When you have your Mac and you put it to sleep, it will automatically switch off your Bluetooth, and then will automatically switch it on again when your Mac awakes. This will ensure that your Bluetooth headphones can't connect to your Mac when it is sleeping. There are also a couple of caveats to note, but the important one here is that if you utilize the Allow Your Apple Watch to Unlock Your Mac feature, this will not work with Bluesnooze, as this requires your Bluetooth to be on at all times. Now, provided that this isn't an issue for you, we can head over and begin the installation process. There are a couple of ways that we can install Bluesnooze, the first of which is to download the latest release as a zip file, or if you utilize Homebrew on your Mac, you can simply copy this one-line command and install it using your terminal and Homebrew. In this example, we're going to head over and download the latest release by simply clicking on the link here. This will take us over to the releases page, where we can see that the latest version is 1.2, and it supports Macs with both Intel and Apple Silicon, but you do need to be on at least macOS version 12.0 or newer. And now simply head down to the assets section of the page and click on the bluesnooze.zip link, and this will download the zip file to our Mac. Now here I am over in Finder, and I have that zip file ready. All I need to do is extract it by double clicking on the zip file itself. And what you will see is I will have the Bluesnooze application file. I could simply double click on it to run it, but for organization's sake, I'm going to drag and drop it over to my applications folder in order to move it there. And now all I need to do is basically run the file. So I'm going to use Spotlight Search, and I'm going to do a quick search for Bluesnooze in order to open the file. I will get a prompt from macOS letting me know that this file was downloaded from the internet and asking me if I'm sure I wish to open it. In this case, I'm going to select to open it. And then the last thing that I need to do is to make sure that the program runs at login. In order to do that, I need to head to my menu bar and I'll find the application icon for Bluesnooze and then click on it and select the option that says launch at login to allow this application to run automatically whenever you sign into your Mac. And that is all we need to do to fix our Bluetooth issues. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you from plenty of Bluetooth heartache in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.